So thanks for dropping by the channel. Subscribe if you're new, and I hope you enjoy the video. So Joseph Parker, he stops Alex Liepaja in the 10th round, 10 one-sided rounds in this fight. Joseph Parker made a fast start in this fight. He really came out, you know, throwing a lot of combinations, trying to get Liepaja out there early on in the round, early on in the first round. And even the commentators at ringside were saying, this looks like it's going to be a short night. Joseph Parker looks like he's keen to make a statement. But one thing I noticed was Liepaja, he was tucking up quite well, and he was taking the sting out of some of the shots that Joseph Parker was throwing. And Joseph Parker, I don't think he was throwing with full power. I think he was focusing more on letting his hands go and just kind of show his more combination punching as opposed to, you know, brute force, you know, power. So Liepaja was able to go a few rounds. But by about the fifth round, Liepaja was shifted a few shots. They weren't necessarily the hardest shots in the world, but he was definitely shifting some punishment in there. He was getting caught with uppercuts. And by about the fifth or sixth round, the Sky commentary team, and even I myself, was thinking, maybe they need this look about stopping this fight. Maybe the referee needs to jump in. Maybe the corner needs to intervene. But they let it keep going. Got into the 10th round. And by then, the writing was on the wall. Liepaja was offering precious little back. And the referee jumped in, stopped the fight. Rightly so. Could have probably done with it a few rounds earlier. But, you know, that is what it is. Originally, this fight, Eric Molina was set to be the opponent for Joseph Parker. That was changed, for whatever reason, to Alex Liepaja. And I said that, realistically, either one is not the greatest, because Molina, he's kind of a fringe contender who is, you know, has spouts of inactivity. Really, he's known for giving Deontay Wilder a few problems in Wilder's first defense WBC title. But since then, came short against Joshua, barely even tried against Joshua, in my opinion. Stopped by Dominic Brazil. He's been stopped in every loss he's had. So I was thinking, you know, Molina, he's not going to give anything really in this fight. Joseph Parker probably stopped him early. And then when they announced that Molina wouldn't be the opponent and then it'd be Liepaja, I kind of thought, well, Liepaja, he's been even more inactive. And, you know, he's even shorter. He's been, you know, stopped by guys like Kevin Johnson, you know, guys who are not known as big punchers. So I kind of thought, you know, this is probably not going to be a great fight. But to be honest with you, I think Liepaja probably was more durable than Molina. I think that if you put Molina in there, because I don't think he's good at tucking up Molina. I don't think he's good defensively. I think he probably has a worse chin, to be honest with you. So I think that if you put Molina in there, it probably wouldn't have went as long. So Alex Liepaja was able to give Joseph Parker a workout. Parker looked good in there. You know, he looked to let the combinations go, letting the fast hands go. And he was going to the head and body as well in this fight, which is always good to see when you can see, like, especially a heavyweight mix up from the head and body, because most of the time you don't tend to see that in the heavyweight division. Especially when you got a shorter opponent like Alex Liepaja, because Alex Liepaja is listed as 6 foot. I'd say probably closer to 5'10", because he did look quite small in this fight. So it was a good performance from Parker. Where does he want to go next? He's been saying he wouldn't mind giving Andy Ruiz a rematch or having a rematch with Ruiz because, as you all know, he's the only guy to beat Andy Ruiz. It was a very close fight back in 2016. Personally, I felt when I watched the first time, Parker won. Rewatching it, definitely make a case for Ruiz winning. It was a very close fight. There's also been talk about Derek Chisora and Alexander Usyk. Derek Chisora, I think, would be the more likely fight. I think that'd be the more likely fight because in one sense, I can kind of see where they're going. They want to maybe give Parker Chisora just to see how he does in comparison to White, because I think that if Deontay Wilder does get made franchise champion by WBC, which is something that we're kind of hearing in the wake of them elevating Canelo the franchise champion, they may end up making Dillian White versus Oscar Rivas for their quote-unquote regular title. I could easily see a rematch between Parker and White, and they might use Chisora as kind of, you know, a stepping stone for Parker. Who knows? I'd definitely be picking Joseph Parker over Derek Chisora, and I think he'd probably have an easier time than White. Just from a stylistic point of view, I think he might have an easier time against Chisora than he would against White. But anyway, let's just go back to this fight. Parker looked good. He wasn't in there with much. Let's not beat around the bush here. But for the most part, he looked good. Let the combinations go, and he was in there against someone who he didn't come to win, but he came to, you know, show his toughness, which is always good. So let me know what you think down below. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, please leave a like, subscribe if you're new, and as always, I will talk to you after.